Yeah, I don't disagree with that, but I think the movement is okay because he did stick it with that left foot, which was the first foot on the back end. And when he moves it, it does move a little, but it really doesn't come completely dislodged where you have to start over with that possession, in my opinion. So it's that back left foot, naturally the right is well in. The third step, which is when the ball kind of is moving as well, the catch is complete at that point. He's met all three elements prior to that left foot hitting the white. So I think they make that a catch. They just put him out at that spot.
So interesting, because he moved the ball, Jason, from his right hand to his left hand.
After review, will the field stand? It's a catch. First down and one.
Confirmed by Ronald Torbert, the biggest play for Shaheed. Thanks so much, Gene. Right on the money once again. So, game situation.
For 1 minute, 50 seconds, please. 150, clock will start on the snap.
Tennessee still with two timeouts left. And if you can get the stop, hold them to a field goal, Tennessee can still have the opportunity to get the football back.
Now the only negative of that play by Shaheed is you went out of bounds. So the Titans didn't have to use one of those two timeouts, would expect these next few plays to be rushed.
Williams. Maybe back to the line of scrimmage. And there is one of the two timeouts remaining by Tennessee.
It's always interesting you get in these situations because they're not really getting any yards. They're actually going backwards. And anytime you have a called run play like that, there is the potential for a holding penalty, which would be a double whammy because it pushes you back and it stops the clock.
No doubt about it. Until you get a point loss for those offensive linemen, you're not blocking against a run. With those guys on that defensive front, for one, right now, they're sending everybody committing to the run. So it's tough to be able to handle that when the defense knows exactly what's coming next.
Trying to quiet the crowd. They've done a pretty good job of that here in New Orleans for the most part, making sure his guys can get off on the snap count, get that snap count advantage.
Tennessee still with a timeout left. Second down coming up. Shaheed. Again on the end of the line. Shaheed comes up the field, wants to stay in bounds. Had a tough time sliding and got crushed by Simmons. But he does stay in and forces Tennessee to call their final timeouts.
That's kind of a gutsy call because he was right near the sideline. And Simmons, I think, tried to bash him out of bounds. Look, Simmons trying to get him out of bounds. Shouldn't go to the head like that. But that was very close. Heads-up play by Shaheed to get down in the field of play.
Coming up next, it's game two of our NFL on CBS doubleheader. Most of you will head to Foxborough to see the defending NFC champion Eagles take on the Patriots. All hail Sunday. The NFL is on CBS, streaming on Paramount Plus. Boy, it's great to have football back. Week one, Chase McCourty, Ross Tucker, Chris Lewis, Amanda Garrett on the sideline. Tennessee without any timeouts left. Third down coming up. They trusted Derek Carr on the third down. Do they do it again, Jason?
I think you continue to run the ball. Their defense has done a good job stopping Tennessee. Trust those guys, run the ball, force them to use another timeout, which will make it that much harder for them.
And if you pick a field goal and the Titans have to go all the way down for a touchdown.
Yes.
Third down approach. Here's a handoff. Williams has the first down, and that just solves it. The ball came out, but he finds it. The usually sure-handed Jamal Williams, and that's how New Orleans, who struggled to run the ball all game long, they get it done in the fourth.
Oh, what a punch out. I mean, that ball was out.
That's Sean Murphy Bunting coming in number zero for the Titans with a right-hand punch. But sometimes it's better to have luck on your side. For Jamal Williams, the ball lands right in front of him, and he's able to pull it back in.
I cannot believe that. That was their best run of the whole game by Jamal Williams. The Titans knew he was going to run it. They've been stuffing him all game. And then third and four to close it out, there's a huge hole for a big game.
And Shaheed was coming in that jet sweep motion again after they just handed it off to him. Now he gave it to Jamal Williams and maybe stretched the defense out a little bit.
As the Saints can handle it, I go back to this offseason. As Carr launches that ball. team that struggled offensively a year ago. New Orleans held their opponents their last eight last year at 20 points or less. Just went 4-4 in those games. And they'll need to get a quarterback who can make a play in a close game with the game on the line. Derek Carr did just that when he found Shaheed on that big third down.
And what did Derek Carr tell us on Friday? He's about to get his favorite part of being an NFL player. He said after the game, after a win, I just like to sit there in my locker and watch all the other guys celebrate. He's like, that's why I play. That's my favorite thing. That moment in the locker room, watching the guys congratulate each other after a win.
And that's a guy that knows how hard it is to win in the NFL. At those 8 years, those 9 years in,